Saltwater crocodiles are formidable apex predators. There are so many of these crocodiles on the north coast of Australia that you can't go far without seeing signs warning you of their danger. But only 50 years ago, this king of the waterways was almost extinct. This is how they've bounced back. This is the saltwater crocodile. It's the largest reptile on Earth and ferociously territorial. Adults can grow to around 6 meters and weigh 1,000 kilograms. Australia actually has two species of crocodiles, the saltwater crocodile and the smaller freshwater crocodile, also known as salties and freshies. In Australia, saltwater crocs are found extensively across the north coast. They live in rivers, wetlands and swamps, and can travel out to sea or along the coast. The majority of salties live in the mangrove-rich waterways of the Northern Territory. The Territory has the most crocodiles and keeps the best data, so that's where we'll focus. Given the ubiquity of crocodiles in the Territory today, it's hard to imagine that only 50 years ago, they were under threat of imminent extinction. In the mid-20th century, crocodile skin was very fashionable. This made crocodile hide incredibly valuable. From 1945 until 1970, there was an intense period of hunting crocodiles for their skin, as many people capitalized on this gold rush. Crocodiles were relentlessly killed, their skin being exported to high-end designer brands. Finally, in 1970, their numbers had dwindled enough that saltwater crocodiles became protected in Western Australia, and the NT in Queensland followed suit a few years later. But after a couple of decades of over-hunting, the crocodile population in the Northern Territory had been thoroughly obliterated and was down to only about 3,000 non-hatchling salties. Crocodile numbers are usually counted as the number of non-hatchlings because while breeding females lay about 50 eggs per year, only 1% of hatchling crocodiles are expected to make it to adulthood. Baby crocodiles are tiny and routinely get eaten by birds, fish, and other crocodiles. With only a small pool of crocodiles left, it wasn't guaranteed that the population numbers would recover. Conservation efforts were started, and it was hoped the salties could bounce back. And bounce back they did. Today there are up to 200,000 saltwater crocodiles in Australia, and the Northern Territory is home to at least 100,000 of these, up from the nadir of 3,000. Crocodile monitoring is routinely undertaken on various rivers throughout the NT. Here are the results for the Adelaide River, showing that we're basically back to peak crocodile on this particular waterway. Unlike some other apex predators, saltwater crocs are far from rare. In 2020, there were 4 non-hatchling crocodiles spotted per kilometre of river surveilled. In fact, crocodiles have been so successful at replenishing their numbers that they're now routinely removed from areas of human population. Darwin, the capital city of the Northern Territory, is home to around 150,000 people. In the last 10 years, an average of 279 crocodiles per year are removed from waterways around Darwin. That's a crocodile caught and removed on most days of the year. 98% of the crocodiles removed are saltwater crocs. Their average length is well in excess of 2 meters. Imagine living in a city around which most days a 2 meter territorial terror full of teeth is trapped, hopefully before posing any danger to people. And crocodiles haven't just increased their numbers, they're also getting bigger. Crocodiles can live a really long time, like 70 years long. It takes decades for them to reach full size. That means that most of the crocodiles hatched in the last 50 years are still growing up. Remember that graph of the Adelaide River that showed the number of crocodiles is plateauing? Well, here's a graph of the same river that measures kilograms of crocodile per kilometre. In other words, how big the crocs are. And crocodiles are huge in the Territory in more than one sense. They're also big business. The wild population has rebounded so much that it now supports harvesting of crocodile eggs for farmed crocodiles. Companies are still making bags and clothes from crocodile skin, and in 2016, 59,000 crocodile skins were exported from Australia. And that's not to mention the extra tourism that these impressive crocs bring to the region. Not only has the conservation of saltwater crocs been successful for business and tourism, but a healthy crocodile population also benefits the territory's groups of Aboriginal people who aren't bound by the hunting protections and can continue to hunt crocodiles in the top end as they've done sustainably for tens of thousands of years. So that's how the largest reptile on Earth was put at risk of extinction only 50 years ago, and how in a remarkably short period of time, their numbers have increased by at least 30-fold in the NT. It's a conservation success story, and it's definitely a reminder to take any warning signs seriously.